Hello and welcome to our webinar for the trinamiX spectroscopy solution. TrinamiX is a brand of BSFSE and we've just recently launched a new solution providing new ways of plastic sorting. I'm Adrian and this is Elizabeth. Elizabeth, you will join me today during the presentation and also introduce the Alliance to End Plastic Waste.
Yes, thank you very much. Welcome from my side. Thank you for inviting me today. The Alliance to End Plastic Waste is a non-profit organization headquartered in Singapore. It has been co-founded by BSF in January 2019, and it is unique because it unites companies from the entire plastic value chain. The Alliance has the vision to end plastic waste in the environment by focusing on four areas: waste management infrastructure, innovation, cleanup, and education. Therefore, it is very important for us to understand how specific types of plastic are recycled and can be sorted in order to be able to move this precious material up the waste hierarchy. Therefore, I'm super excited to be here today and to see what you guys at trinamiX are doing.
So let's start with a demonstration. I would like to demonstrate our entire solution, which consists of the spectrometer, which is basically the hardware we have. It fits nicely in my palm, so it's a portable device. The measurement head is on top, but our solution also consists of the cloud, which runs the algorithms or chemometry, and the results are then being displayed on the smartphone app, as you can see here. So let's do some measurement. I would say we start with this coffee capsule. I put it on top of the spectrometer, push the button, so the measurement starts, it's being calculated, and the result is being shown on the smartphone. When you have measured a couple of times, you can look into the history of your measurements where you can see the spectra and when you have measured it. So at any time you can go back in the history and see whatever you have measured. We also have a couple of other samples here. This is a kid's swimming aid, which is also some typical plastic piece that we can distinguish from other materials. As you see, the result is being displayed very fast. And as a third sample, we have this kids toy. As you see, we have a summer vacation topic here today. I hope plenty of you can enjoy a nice summer vacation. And this one is PE. When you have performed a couple of measurements during the day, you can also look into the webpage and look into your history where you can see all these measurements and you can make an analysis, you can download it, you can see trends, and you can add additional data to these measurements. Now that we have seen how the solution works, I would also like to introduce the theory behind it. So, as we've learned, this is our spectrometer, which has a measurement head. And the idea is that this spectrometer is sending out light, which is being reflected by the surface of the specimen and being caught by the detector, which is inside the spectrometer. This detector is then responsible for translating the optical signals into electrical signals, which are being sent into the cloud, where our smart algorithms translate them into the answer. Actually, these smart algorithms compare the signal that they receive from the spectrometer with the database that we have already put into the cloud. The results then are being sent back to the smartphone where they are being displayed and shown to you in the way you've seen. The differentiation of the material is actually done by looking at their spectra. As you can see in the slide we have shown to you now, each material type has a different spectra, which is basically like a fingerprint. And analyzing the material is just looking at the spectra and comparing it to what we already have in the database. Now we show to you a slide, which is showing a list of material types that we have already in the database. In case you don't see the material that you would like to analyze, please reach out to us so we can add it to the database and provide the full solution to you.
Thank you, Adrian, for the super interesting demonstration and explanation. I do have a couple of questions. So I saw the data displayed on the smartphone and the algorithms also run in the cloud, But is it also possible to access the information from a regular computer?
Yes, it is. We provide a platform so each user can log in and see all the measurements he did in the past. It's also possible to add additional data to these measurements, just like pictures, and over time you can see trends and make further analysis with these data.
And what are your next steps? How will the technology adapt to the challenges that the industry faces in the future?
Well, our system is very open, so we can always adapt to customer requirements or to future market trends. We do this by adding new materials like composites or new blends, or even more complex measurement tasks like multilayer foils. We can also add something like textiles for textile recycling. So this means that for our users, this is a really forward-minded solution. They profit from every improvement we do, and actually we improve from each user that uses our solution.
And this means that the user doesn't have to buy new hardware?
Exactly. All this works with the same hardware.
Great. So this is really impressive technology. Thank you so much for demonstrating it today.
Thank you very much for joining me. Goodbye.
Bye.